every kid has a bug period. I had mine. I just never grew out of mine. Somehow I stayed with it. And I found no greater joy when I was about 9 or 10 years old and collecting spiders and ants and especially butterflies. I began actually when I lived in Washington, D.C., our nation's capital, for 2 years. Although a Southerner, I'd come up there because my father was a federal employee, and after 2 years we went back down to the hometown of Mobile, Alabama. And in Washington, I came up with a real interest in animals because our apartment was within walking distance of the National Zoo, which is a wonderland for a kid, free, wander through there anytime you want. I was a trolley ride from the U.S. National Museum of Natural History, one of the great museums in the world. And it was a paradise. I spent time collecting insects and then going over and looking at them in the museum and imagining what it must be like to be in Arthur Conan Doyle's Lost World while I was in the zoo. And then I also spent a lot of time wandering around a park called Rock Creek Park that winds all around the zoo. That was my equivalent of a wilderness when I was a little kid. And so I guess by the time I was ready to go back to Mobile and then encounter a subtropical fauna, butterfly species that are found only in the warm temperate, very warm temperate or subtropical zones occurring there, which didn't occur in Washington, and the great, much greater diversity of plants and animals, many of them not well studied, I guess by that time I would have thought it odd that anybody would want to be anything else but an entomologist, or at least a naturalist, a biologist. Actually, I became an entomologist instead of a specialist on something else like birds because I was and am handicapped. When I was a kid, before we went to Washington, at the age of 7, I was in a military academy. All real Southerners want to put their kids in the military category, or at least they did in the 30s. That was a Southern tradition. The highest one could aspire to was West Point or the Naval Academy and have a son, a peacetime or a wartime, an officer in the armed services, and those few academies were tough places. But in any case, about that time, I spent a summer in a place called Paradise Beach. I spent all my time fishing. I guess I was about 7 years old. And one day, I pulled up what's called a pinfish. These are fish with needle-like spines in the dorsal fin. One of them got me in the eye, and that resulted in a traumatic cataract. I didn't even tell anybody about the excruciating pain because I was afraid they might stop me from fishing. But later, when I only had vision in one eye, I discovered, as all true naturalists do when I began trying to study birds, you've got to go through your Roger Torrey Peterson stage with field guides and look at birds if you're going to be a real naturalist sometime in your teens. And I discovered that I was a lousy bird watcher, partly because of my vision. And I couldn't see them. You can't judge distance very well. Furthermore, I also have a condition where I don't hear the upper registers very well. So I couldn't hear them, I couldn't spot them. How was I going to be a halfway decent ornithologist? So I just loved insects anyway, so I decided at about the age of 16 that I was going to be an entomologist. And I was so dedicated to it that even though I never really got a very good background in the school systems of Alabama in mathematics or physics or chemistry, my interest in the background I'd built up in natural history propelled me right on through to the Harvard Graduate School and then quickly a postdoctoral fellowship in Harvard's Society of Fellows, which gave me 3 years of completely free and fully supported research.